juice. New AP. She got it juice.
Oh, I got you juicy entertainment news for Tuesday. Dennis Rodman. Now, that's someone we have not heard about for a long time in the headlines. Well, he is making headlines for refusing to wear a mask. Now, that's been happening to a lot of celebs lately, and he was flying from L.A. to Fort Lauderdale yesterday morning and was told allegedly several times to put his mask back on by JetBlue staffers while he was in the plane. Now, law enforcement say that he would at first oblige, and then he would pull his mask down, saying that he was having trouble breathing. Well, that's a big no-no, especially since there is a federal mask mandate in effect for all airports and airlines that they have to abide by, otherwise they have to pay major fines. Not to mention that, of course, the new wave of COVID that's on the rise. And, of course, cops were waiting for him when he landed. Someone on the flight said that Rodman was in first class and was asked four different times to keep his face covering over his mouth and nose. And he constantly lowered it to his chin and wouldn't immediately put it back on when he was asked. Now, deputies from the Broward County Sheriff's Office spoke to him when he landed. He was cooperative, and in the end, they let him go without giving him a ticket. But, I mean, I understand it. When you have to wear and you're in the airport for hours, can you imagine? Hours and hours doing the traveling, going through security, waiting on the plane, in your flight. That's a long flight from L.A. to Miami as well. That's all the way cross-country. So I kind of get it, having trouble breathing. Like, it is, you know, it's the reality of what's happening nowadays. And it looks like their 15 minutes of fame has come to an end. The internet sensation, the Island Boys. You know who I'm talking about. The two twin brothers, the two white boys, Fly Soldier and Cody Ekid. Well, they were booed at a Jake Paul and Tyron Woodley fight last night in Tampa when they were walking to their ringside seats. A tweet was circulating with some footage of what had happened saying, Island Boys, not a lot of fans in Tampa getting booed out of the building. They were heckled. The footage shows the crowd like attacking them pretty much. They were surrounded by their entourage and they were getting really aggressive, throwing things at them. They even had a full beer thrown at them. Like, get out of the building. Now, Jake Paul knocked Woodley out in the fight last night, and it seems that Tampa fans might have wanted to see the Island Boys knocked out. And this is not the first time that they've been publicly booed and probably will not be the last. The end of last month, they were not well received during their first performance at Club Live. The crowd did not hesitate to let them know how much they dislike them. Island Boys, yeah, 15 minutes, gone. And that's your juicy entertainment news for Tuesday. Have yourselves a fabulous, fabulous afternoon. I've got some Lady E, Rick Carey. Turn it up and feel the music.